And good morning, everyone. So it is currently 7 a.m. I've been awake for actually quite a while. I've been awake since 4-ish. I actually have a very, very strong case of insomnia, so I roughly get like 3 to 4 hours of sleep at night. So I've been awake for quite a while now. Usually when I wake up that early, which is pretty much every single day, I just lay in my bed for a bit. I read, sometimes I listen to music, but usually I do more of like reading and very calming things. I don't have my phone with me in my bed usually, just today, because I'm filming this video, which I didn't say. Hi, welcome. This is my morning rituals, my morning routine. I'm gonna share it with you. This is just how I start the day, and I hope you enjoy it. So one of the first things that I do in the morning is just having some water. I always have a glass of water by my bed. I also like to drink during the nighttime whenever I'm awake, because as I said, I usually don't get a lot of sleep. And if you were wondering why I'm so high to the ceiling, it's because I actually have a bunk bed. Yeah, I'm a grown-up living with a bunk bed, but I have a one-room apartment, so even my kitchen, everything is in this one room, and just having a bunk bed kind of gives it another little room, and I love to sit up here. So this next part might be a bit weird, but I like to sleep naked, and as I said, there are so many windows in this apartment that pretty much all of my neighbors are gonna see me the second that I leave my bed. So I have my PJs always up here with me, and that's usually when I put them on right before I leave the bed. So during the mornings, it's usually pretty chilly in my apartment, so I always put on a little jacket or a cardigan over my PJs, just so I don't freeze. And that's pretty much the final thing I do before I leave the bed. So let's start the day. So right after I left my bed, I head to the kitchen to get another glass of water before I start journaling. So I just grab a glass and fill it up with water. I keep crystals in my water to energize it, and then I'm also grabbing some vitamin B12. I live vegan, and so it's very important for me to take care of my nutritional needs, and that's what I'm currently taking to supplement my vitamins. So then I just head over to my vanity and grab an incense. I burn incense pretty much all day long, and I just really like to choose one from the many that I have, and then I just put it in a little holder thingy and light it up. I also use the incense to light my candle, and as soon as that is done, I grab my journals. I have one regular journal and then one for poems, and I just get them, sit down, and start writing. So I usually write down how my night was, and then also everything else that I have on my mind right now, everything that I've been thinking about these past few hours. And then I also like to write down some positive affirmations and everything that I'm trying to focus on that day. So next up, I grab my poetry journal. I actually made this myself, and I like to write poems in here. I don't feel inspired to do that every single day, but whenever I do, I really enjoy it. So next up, I head over to my closet to pick out some workout clothes. I usually just wear some sort of shorts and a shirt. Then I lay down those two little rugs. I usually use them to work out on those, and I start by stretching, just doing some regular stretches and then going into a yoga flow. I just pretty much do whatever my body tells me to do. And then I start my workout. I just do some abs, thighs, and arm exercises. I didn't include everything in here because it would take way too much room. And once I'm finished with the workout, I just do some stretches to cool down. And then I fold the rug so that I can sit a bit more comfortable. I grab my candle and also my incense and my water, and I will start meditating.
So with my meditations, I really try to get in touch with myself and just focus on me and being kind to myself and also being thankful. And then I also try to focus on my daily affirmations, which are to be good in recovery and also treat myself kind, work but not work too much. Then I just put on a jacket and some socks because it's still pretty cold in my apartment, and I open the windows to just let in some fresh air, and then I fill up my little vase and start watering all of my plants. So then I take down all of the stuff that I've been keeping on my record player and turn it on. So this morning I decided to listen to some Donovan. So I pretty much listen to music all day long, and in the mornings I really like to listen to a bit more calming music. So it's usually either Simon and Garfunkel or Donovan or Bob Dylan or something quite similar to those. So then I head back to my kitchen to boil some water. I am a huge coffee lover, and I have this mill where you just put in the coffee and then you grind it with your hands. Then I just use this porcelain filter. I put a filter bag in it and my grinded coffee. And then all that's left is just to wait for the water to boil. And while that is happening, I take my tea. I like to drink loose tea, and I just put a bit in my teapot and wait for the water to boil. Then I just use the porcelain filter and put it on my coffee pot and fill that up with hot water. So I just make myself some coffee. I either take my coffee black or with a bit of almond milk, and today I decided to go with a bit of almond milk. And yeah, now I'm gonna go to the bathroom, wash my face, kind of get ready, and I will take you with me, so let's go. My apartment is still such a mess. I just moved in 2 weeks ago and I still need to get so much done. So this is my bathroom. It is one of the rooms that is not done yet at all, but as I said, I just moved in and I'm still kind of working on it. But my morning routine portion in the bathroom is so quick and easy. I don't like to do a lot of things. So the first thing that I usually do is wash my face. Let's start with that. Gotta put the hair up. This is such a Biba-inspired cute little velvet headband. I feel like I should wear it more often, but for some reason I always end up just wearing it to wash my face and then like on some rare occasions, but I feel like I should wear it more. What do you think? To wash my face, I actually use soap. I try to not use plastic and like anything that really isn't good for the environment. So I just use a soap. This comes without any packaging and it's very environmentally friendly. The next thing that I use is this toner, and I really like this one because you buy these glass containers and then you just go back to the store and they refill it. So there is no plastic packaging, as I said, really trying to save the environment. So I just spray that onto my face, kind of lightly tap it in. Has anyone else been breaking out so much due to wearing masks all the time? Like, don't get me wrong, I know that it's important to wear them and I'm not complaining. I just feel like there has to be some way to deal with all of these breakouts. So if anyone has some ideas, I'll be very happy if you would share them with me. And then I'm using some facial oil. So oil is actually better for your skin than like any cream or lotion would be, just because the less ingredients a product has, the better it usually is for your skin. So oil is usually better than any sort of lotion. I'm just using some drops. Oh, also this comes without plastic packaging, so we love that over here. This smells so nice. It's rose oil. It's very good for your skin. So I'm just massaging that on. Then I use some deodorant. I actually make my deodorant myself. I don't even know how often I said environmentally friendly and package free in this video, but as I said, I'm just an environmentalist and it's very important to me, so I make my deodorant myself. I am almost out of it, as you can see, but it's very easy. If you're interested in like the whole topic, I could definitely make a video talking about that and sharing this recipe with you, because it's really, really easy. It saves you a lot of money, it saves you a lot of packaging, and it's just very good for you. And I'm perfectly fine with this. Like, I don't need any crazy sort of deodorant. I just use this once a day and I'm perfectly fine.
Then I take this out.
My roots are absolutely horrible. I talked to my hairdresser. They're reopening again in like 2 weeks. Due to lockdown, everything is closed. And as I said, I'm not complaining about all of these things because I see the importance of it, but this is just not cute. If you were wondering why I've been wearing hats all the time lately, that's why, because I feel like I can't go anywhere looking like that.
We're back in the kitchen to make breakfast. I am not a breakfast person. I don't like to eat breakfast, but I'm currently in recovery. I am struggling with an eating disorder, and ever since I started recovery, I am trying really hard to eat 3 meals a day. And yeah, it's very hard for me, but I really try to stick to it. And one thing that I've really been loving for breakfast lately is just some oatmeal and some fruit. So that's what we're gonna make today.
I keep my fruits in this little thing that I make myself. I have some
other things up here, like some onions and some garlic, and then usually I have my fruits down here. And
as you can see, I can choose from pears and pears, so let's go with a pear, I'd say.
So I use 2 spoons of oatmeal, and then I fill that up with some tea and let it soak, and I cut my pear. And to finish my oatmeal, I just add a splash of almond milk. And then I try to center myself and say a Buddhist prayer just to be thankful for the food. And I wasn't sure if I'm gonna let this scene in, but honestly, I just wanted to show you that it's okay if you're struggling with a lot of things. I'm struggling with eating very, very much. And yeah, I just decided to keep it in to show you guys that you are not alone.
As you saw, I like to drink loose tea, which one is because of the packaging. As I said, I'm very conscious about like packaging and all of these things. And the other is just that I can kind of like measure out how much I want and how strong I want my tea to be, which I really like. I just drink my tea with this straw. This is a yerba straw, so I usually drink yerba tea with it. But I think it works perfectly for any sort of loose tea. It just kind of has this little filter down here, which takes out all of the chunks and pieces. And for me, it's just a very easy way to drink tea.
So I basically try to stay off my phone for as long as possible in the morning. I usually don't go on my phone until after I get dressed, which is what I do after having breakfast. So I like to read while having breakfast. Currently I'm reading The Catcher in the Rye. I read this like 2 times before, I think, but it's just one of my favorite books. I think it's such an amazing story. And if you haven't read it yet, I can highly recommend you to read it. It's by J.D. Salinger, The Catcher in the Rye. But I feel it's so popular, probably everyone has read it by now.
And then I just read and eat breakfast and sometimes look outside. I just really love this place to eat.
I just finished breakfast and now I'm back from brushing my teeth, and we're in my closet and it's time to pick out what I'm gonna wear today. Let's see. It is freezing outside. It is very, very cold, but I'm kind of leaning towards wearing a dress. Maybe I'll just put on a dress and then a turtleneck underneath it. I feel like that might be a good idea. This might be cute. I haven't worn this in quite a while. Ooh, I'm kind of feeling color. Is anyone else always wanting to dress colorful when it's cold? Also, it's super sunny today, so that might be nice. I think I'm gonna go with this one. This is so cute. Yeah, I think we're gonna go with this one. And then just a turtleneck.
white one, very simple, and then some socks.
So that's the dress. I just added some tights and a turtleneck to kind of keep me warm. And now I'm thinking about wearing shoes. So I usually wear shoes inside just because it's so cold in my apartment. Like, it's kind of okay, but the floors are extremely cold, so I always wear shoes. Let's do these. So if you saw my shoe collection, I talked a bit about these, but I just wear them a lot. They're very, very comfortable, and I feel like they're the perfect pair of shoe to wear at home. Also, if you are interested in seeing like my entire closet, I can definitely film like a closet tour or something. Just leave me a comment below telling me if you would be interested in seeing that, and I will film it for you.
I just put on the shoes. I think they look very cute with the outfit. Let me show you. Yeah, I just feel like they match the whole look very well. So let's move on to jewelry.
So this is where I keep all of my jewelry. Got my sunglasses, got my rings, my necklaces, and I just really like to look through and just decide what I want to wear today. One thing that I definitely want to wear is this gorgeous ring. I got it sent by a company called Crescent Treasures. They are based in England and they make beautiful gold-plated jewelry. These necklaces that I'm wearing, I also got sent by them. And as I said, they're from England. Everything that they make is gold-plated and they donate a big part of their proceeds. So if you wanna check them out, click the link in my bio and you can save a couple of percentages and just look around and find some beautiful gems.
Definitely have to reorganize this at some point. Let's see. Yeah, I feel like these will be cute.
So these are the earrings I decided to go with, and this is the ring collection of today. As you have probably seen by now, I just really love to wear a lot of rings. I wear plenty of them every single day, and this is what I picked out for today. Yeah, that's it with today's video. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you were wondering, no, I don't wear makeup every single day. I kind of just have to run some errands today, edit a video, and also prepare something for a shoot tomorrow. That's what I will do now as I go on with my day. I don't really see a purpose in wearing makeup today, and also I just don't feel like it, so I won't do it. So that's it for today's video. If you like it, I would love you to give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, and maybe share it with a friend. It really supports me, and it would mean the world to me if you would take a bit of time to support this channel. I hope you're having an amazing day. Go out, enjoy the sunshine, take yourself some time to focus on you, your needs, and your mental health today, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye, guys!